lives, to poison our water, our food, the very dirt itself we live on, to add to the deadly brew of chemicals.
Those events are going to told new people about it. Today we found new people at our event in the city health park in Berkeley. So it's a slow process, like I said, but it's growing. It's going to keep growing. But we cannot let up. We cannot slack in the pace because...
And the Susanoo is all jungle, and Izanami is a big mountain, and then Sun Goddess, Amaterasu is Sun Goddess, and another one is a Moon God. So he wrote all this, used all these gods to, you know, describe at the moment of our life now. So I think we should go back to that, those ages. Not really, but you know, we should know it.
I beg your indulgence for one more short thing. Some of you may be aware of a man named Mark Schwartz, who lives in Berkeley and was a very important member of the Occupy movement. He still is, but he's the man who the train hit in Berkeley and removed his leg. And he's given me a very short three-line poem that he's giving to the Fukushima anthology that I'd like to give in his honor. He's in recovery with a prosthetic, learning how to use that. But if any of you know him from the Occupy movement, just speak to me and I'll get you in touch with him. Mark Schwartz, Fukushima Daiichi, you killed my child in California, my earth.
Thank you. So, the council never comes down. So, we need to protest. This is the attitude of government, Japanese government and then nuclear industry. The Fukushima accident is, of course, caused by the tsunami and big earthquake, but not only that, human error, human irresponsibility, and the collusion of government and then nuclear industry. This is typical Japanese government, the attitude of the they try to cover the mess, cover the problem. But we against and condemn the Japanese nuclear policy. So please join the dying-in. Whoever wants to die on the sidewalk, just lie down. We're going to mark the, your outline and maybe 5-10 minutes. So let's do.
Consulate
should not be receiving a letter by hand. We have to send by mail. But I don't see anywhere that Japanese law said must send by mail.
That I saw so many cars piled up on the beach, just stretching, without having to be removed, because they had no money to remove them. I saw a 11-story hospital near the water that was the tidal wave that had overwhelmed it and totally devastated the building. The building is up, but there are no patients in there. There's no hospital medical activity in that building. The horror that is there, it is just absolutely, it is shocking. No human should have ever gone through that. The people there told me 20,000 people's lives were lost. Again, this one dead in December 2012. So I know the suffering, I've seen it. And the worst thing that I felt is that the Japanese people, especially in that region, do not know, they are not educated, they are not informed by the government about what's truly going on. They're living there in that area, and it takes me to have to send communications and information to see them from here, so that they would know. YouTube, there. So please keep up the work and keep sending things there. Because people there are not getting the news. They're not getting the straight information. And I also encourage you, go there too. Go there and meet with those people in that region. Fukushima, Iwate, Sendai, this is the Tohoku region of Japan. To see yourself, the shock, because it is really, truly shocking to see it all. Okay.
Thank you. think about it.
Throw it down into
Photographer.
Well,
why are you here today?
I'm in the media, yes. Yeah,
you're media?
I have